Placing a naso-oesophageal tube and feeding. To place a naso-oesophageal tube, you will need the following equipment: local anaesthetic drops, proxymetocaine used for ophthalmic examination, naso-oesophageal feeding tube of the appropriate size, cats 4 to 6 French, dogs 4 to 10 French, permanent marker pen, lubricating jelly, tape, super glue or tissue bonding glue, Elizabethan collar, white open weave bandage, 5 ml syringe, sterile water for injection, and liquid food drawn up and prepared as described in the preparing food for naso-oesophageal feeding video. To place a naso-oesophageal tube, take the patient's head so that the nose is pointing to the ceiling and apply a few drops of local anaesthetic into the nose. When holding the patient's head in this way, it can be useful to place your fingers over the patient's eyes so they cannot see what is coming towards them. While the local anaesthetic is taking effect, the naso-oesophageal tube length can be measured. When in place, the naso-oesophageal tube should lie in the distal oesophagus. The tube should not enter the stomach, as this will cause gastric reflux due to the tube passing through the cardiac sphincter. Therefore, the tube should be measured to approximately the 9th rib. This can be done by counting backwards from the last rib, as demonstrated. The tube should be marked with a pen, so you know when to stop when placing the tube. Before insertion into the nose, the tube should be lubricated with some jelly to allow ease of passage through the nasal cavity. The patient's head should then be held as before and the tube inserted ventrally and medially into the nose. The first couple of inches should be guided into the nose quite quickly to prevent the patient from sneezing it out. Afterwards, the rest of the tube can be fed fairly slowly with the patient's head in a natural position, allowing the patient to swallow the tube down into the oesophagus. The tube should be checked to ensure it has not been guided into the trachea by attaching a 5 ml syringe onto the end of the tube and drawing back. If the tube is in the oesophagus, a vacuum should be felt in the syringe due to the oesophagus collapsing down on the tube. If the tube has been misplaced into the trachea, then air will be easily aspirated, and so the tube should be withdrawn and then placed again. As a second check, 5 ml of sterile water for injection should then be injected down the tube. If coughing is observed, then the tube may be in the wrong place. Injection of the sterile water should therefore be stopped immediately and the tube withdrawn. Once the tube has been confirmed to be correctly in place, we can ultimately confirm location on a radiograph. It can be secured to the patient by attaching 2 pieces of tape to the tube to make butterfly wings, one approximately 1 inch from the nose and another 2 to 3 inches away. A small amount of glue should be applied to the tapes and one stuck in between the eyes and another on top of the head. Ensure the tapes are stuck onto hair, as directly onto the skin will cause burning and difficult removal. To prevent patient interference, an Elizabethan collar should be placed and secured with white open weave bandage. When feeding the patient, the food should be prepared as demonstrated before on the previous video. Before the patient is fed, it is essential the tube is checked before each feed to ensure that it is still correctly in place by using the checks described after placing the tube. The food can then be administered down the tube slowly to avoid vomiting. Once all the food has been given, the remaining 5 ml of sterile water for injection can be flushed down the tube to prevent any blockages occurring. The tube should then be recapped and stuck onto the Elizabethan collar ready for the next feed.